Are you tired of typing out the same email over and over again? What happened if I told you that there's a way that you can save time, ensure consistency, and look professional all with just a couple of clicks? Today, I want to show you how to use email templates in Microsoft Outlook. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. The biggest reason why I like to use templates in Microsoft Outlook is that it saves me time. But another reason is error reduction. So once I go ahead and create this email template and it can be fully formatted in links, with a simple click, it can go in and I don't have to worry about those errors because I've already proofread it once. But sometimes if you're typing it over and over again, you can get those errors. So everything's going to stay more professional. Now I'm using the new Outlook here, and you can use this in the older version of the Outlook if that's what you're using as well. But let's go ahead and show you where you're going to access this. I'm going to go up top here and create a new message. Now you can see that my ribbon has changed and I have a lot more tabs across the top. Under the message tab, if I just go across the ribbon here and take a look at apps, I'm going to click on apps and you can see that there's different apps I can quickly add. My templates is right here. If it's not showing up here, if you're using the older version, you might have to go to the add apps and search for it and add it this way. But I'm going to go ahead and I could click on this, but I'm going to go and pin this. So I'm going to go and right click and hit pin here. So what that did is it gave me quick access to my templates. So now if I go ahead and click on it, I have these pre-created ones from Microsoft here that I can use. So at any time, if I just click on it, you can see how it just goes right into this. So depending which one you need, you could have numerous different ones that you can quickly click on. Now, I want to show you how to create one. But the other thing I want to point out, this is all being saved with your Microsoft 365. If I jump over to, let's say, Outlook on the web, and I'm just using a browser here logged in, notice that I still have my apps here and I still have my templates here, and anything I create will be in this one. So I could be on a different computer somewhere and just log into the web and I'll still have access to those templates we created. So I'm just going to go back to my desktop Outlook and let's go ahead and create a brand new one. If you hover over any of the pre-made ones, you'll see right away you can delete these. So if I go ahead and it's gone, or you can edit it. So if you like some of the Microsoft ones and just want to quickly edit, you can go ahead and change the message. If I want to quickly add a simple one, I could click on template. And if it was just a simple one to confirm something and I wanted to give a message and I'll just say, please confirm, that's how quick it is to type something in. And as soon as I go ahead and save it, you can see this is one of the ones here. But what happens if you want to do something a little bit more complex and longer? I could go ahead and type things in here, but it's a little harder to format it. So if I go ahead and cancel, and let's say if I just go back to my message over here, and let's say I typed out this message. So I just went and typed everything out. I could have it all formatted like this. So let's say this is just a follow-up email. Let's say you give a lot of these follow-up emails and you just want to be able to put in the key points, but you want the information the same. So once I go ahead and write my email in here, I can go ahead and copy this. So I'm just going to go Control C and I go to template. And if this is going to be follow-up, I'll just say this is follow-up. And I can paste it right in here. So if I hit save, now I have this one ready to go. So let's give it a try. So if I just go ahead and delete this one here, and I'm gonna go ahead and just click on new, I'm gonna click on my templates, and it shows it right here. If I click on it, it's right inside my email. So you can see how that can save you a lot of time. Let's do one more example here where we can do a little bit more formatting, and I'll show you how you can just add it to your templates. So in this email example that I just wrote, it's to an employee about a quarterly performance review. Maybe if you have a business that you're sending out a lot of these, another great way to use these templates. Now, I wanted to point out you can add other type of formatting. So let's say here, confirm your availability. I want this to stand out. I could go ahead and highlight this or change the text color on any of these. And I can also add links. So I could go to a certain word if I wanted to and go ahead and add the link through here, or I could go at the end and maybe I want to add a document. So I'm just going to use the forward slash, and from my OneDrive, I'm just going to pick this one. Now, once I have this all placed in, just like I showed you before, if I go ahead and select it all, Control C to copy, go up to my templates, I'm going to go and just click templates, paste it in, and I can give this just a name again. So if this is going to be, I'll just call this performance, like so, and save it. So let's go test this one out. I'll just close this, delete this message. We'll open up a brand new one. We'll click on my templates. And if we look at, here's the performance. If I click on it, there's the formatting here that I did. There's the document. Now, with the power of Microsoft 365, if I jump over and take a look at my online Outlook, all these will follow me over. So I have a email open. If I click on templates, take a look at this, they're going to follow me to here. So I hope you like this tip about how to use templates in Microsoft Outlook. Like I said, this can save you a lot of time and take away those errors as well. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.